Need more help or just want to show your support? Then head over to my Patreon and join my team, where you can get exclusive content like ebooks and bonus plays, as well as early access to my vids and more. Link in the description below. All right, welcome back, YouTubers and Madden fans. This is Madden Money Shot, bringing you something a little different today. I got some more mutt tips. We're going to do some updated budget beasts. We're going to stick to the elites. I know the last budget beast video I put out before the game came out, I had a lot of gold cards in there and a lot of silver cards too, which obviously at this point your team's probably a lot higher. It's probably past the point where that's helping you out, unless you're playing salary cap or something like that. That'd be about the only scenario where you probably would be using guys like that. But I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to stick to the elites. We're going to just do an all elite category. Don't pay attention to my overall up there. That's not my actual overall right now. I'm trying to do, I'll show you my team real quick. I'm trying to do some solos. We basically have to put in like, I might be doing the gauntlet solos, where you have to put in like four guys from the Jaguars and the Colts and all kind of stuff. So my team looks pretty crazy right now. But for the most part, you know, the only updates that I made from the last time, if you guys follow my mutt team videos, the only additions I really made, I went out and I created a second tier Aaron Donald. I'll probably work him up throughout the year. The next tier, I think I gotta buy like a 90 overall Aaron Donald. That's gonna be expensive. That's gonna cost money. So other than that, I did the super, what are they called, the superhero challenges. I took Cam Chancellor. I heard some other YouTubers talking smack about Cam Chancellor, but what they were saying, he's too slow, 80 speed. If you upgrade him, he maxes out at 84. But if you play cover three like I do, who typically your cover three safety plays down the box, that 95 hit power is going to be epic. I can't wait to get that guy pumped up to the 91 version. It's getting so hard to not spend money, because I really would like to buy what I need to get that guy right now. Because you can see, I got the 91 Steve Atwater, who's also like a hit power machine, creates crazy fumbles. He's got a 92 hit power. He creates a lot of fumbles at a 92 hit power. He's 6'3", so if I can pair him with a 6'4" Cam Chancellor playing down the box, which I'm not sure what his upgraded hit power is, but it's probably like a 96 or a 97. But if I could upgrade that and have him in there, good lord, am I going to be knocking people's teeth out. So I'm totally jacked for that. Other than that, like I said, this team isn't really put together right now. I don't want to mess it up, because I'm trying to do a lot of solos right now. Like I said, I don't spend money on my squad. That's why it's so important to have these budget beasts. So let's go ahead and let's go back into the auctions and trades. We're going to go ahead and figure out where these budget beasts are. What is going on, by the way, with the market? Every time you go into the auction house, it resets you back to like some stupid, like, man, EA, man, you get your stuff together, EA, for real. So like I said, whether you have a team that's a low 80 or a high 80, I'm going to try to move up as I go along through this video. So the next tier guy, I would say, would be about the 83 range with Carson Wentz. Carson Wentz, team of the week player, one of my personal favorites, obviously being an Eagles fan, but his speed is more than adequate at 78. That's barely, you know, it's almost an 80. That's that guy, he's mobile. But the accuracies are a lot better than Tyrod Taylor's. His throw power is a lot higher than 80. To me, 80, if you're trying to throw deep, is kind of the minimum. So a really good card. Like I said, team of the week, you can get him for about around 8, around 9, so you're still not spending too much. And then if you have a slightly higher team, I think Matt Stafford, if you want somebody that's a deep accuracy throw power type of quarterback without mobility, I'd say that Matt Stafford right now is one of the best ones. You can get him for just above 20K. His throw power at a 90 is, there's not a lot higher in the game. He's known for his arm, and his 68 speed is relatively mobile. He's actually, you can move the pocket with him pretty nice. Moving up to the 83, I got Tevin Coleman. This is a guy who I still have on my team. I keep him as a backup, my third down back. He's got the, you know, one of the best speeds, 88. You know, there's higher speed guys, but for the price, you can't beat about 15K. But this guy right here, he's got enough power to work inside and enough speed to get outside, a complete back. I'm going to finish this off with a power back, LeGarrette Blount, an 85 overall. He's selling for about 18. He's got a 90 truck, 81 speed. You know, like I said, the 90 truck is one of the higher ones. Compared to the other LeGarrette Blount card that just came out, which is also an 85, the difference there, you actually get a slower running back with higher trucking, a 95 truck. But he's cost about 10,000 more. So if you want a power back, he's going to be one of the best ones to get out there. All right, this guy here is going to take the place of my 83. I think Tyreek Hill might have been in my original budget beast video too. I'm not sure, because technically he sells for a lot more than his overall would indicate. He's got a 90 speed though. That's why people are paying for this guy. But if you want a speedy receiver, that's around the price range that the 83 overall value was that I continue to use. So 16K is about what you can get this guy for. And then we're going to go one more wide receiver. I mean, I'm going to try to do this in threes. Terrell Pryor, to me, is one of my favorite receivers. 6'4". more than adequate speed at an 85. You're not going to find a lot of 6'4" receivers with that type of speed and pretty good catching stats. I mean, this guy overall, he just plays like a monster. Really good chemistry, too, with the vertical. Next up, we'll do tight ends. The first tight end I'm going to show is Jared Cook. This is another guy that was in my original video. He's an 81 overall. He's 6'5 with an 80 speed. He's actually got pretty good blocking, too, if I remember correctly. I'll try to go down and find it while I'm talking. But either way, a 74 run block. I mean, that's really good. I mean, this guy right here, you're getting for like under 6K, and he's a really good card. He's good in every way. You know, to me, he's way better than his overall. Keep it moving to the defensive side of the ball. One of the better cards that they just released in the 80 overall version is the Jadeveon Clowney card. 78 speed, 90 power move. I mean, this guy right here is one of the best cards in the game, no matter what version they release. Just came out. Make sure you check this guy out. Another defensive end that I've been using for some time now is somebody that you use to complete a set. The 81 overall John Abraham, which is selling for about 13K. He's at 82 speed, which is top notch. I mean, there's not a lot of defensive ends that have better speed than that. His acceleration is pretty high too. His overall, you know, power moves and stuff like that really aren't that great because, like I say, he's only part of completing a set. But take it from me, this guy gets me a lot of sacks with that speed and acceleration. All right, so next up for somebody's a little bit more of a run stuffer, we got the 83 defensive tackle Mean Joe Green. This is another guy's part of a set, and they've kind of toned these guys down from last year. Sometimes last year, the guys that were parts of sets were better than a lot of players out there on the market. But this guy here, if you compare his stats, his 82 strength, 82 tackle, 82 blocks, at 80 power move, 93 play rec. If you compare them to other defensive tackles, they actually compare to guys that are much higher, guys that are like in the 85 range, like Chris Baker. I was just comparing him to this guy, and he's got very similar stats. So you're getting him for about half the price or more if you can get him on bid. Like this guy right here is 10K on bid. So you know what I mean? That guy right there, and he's a little bit faster too. So he's really good. Really good player. Now this guy right here, I don't know what EA was thinking. Anthony Barr is, to me, one of the best linebackers in this game. He's only an 81 overall this year. He is just a playmaker. I send this guy on blitzes all the time. His speed is what's going to get it done. A2 speed. I don't know what the deal is. I mean, if the guy hasn't played good lately, I don't know. But he plays so much better than his ratings, regardless. I mean, I don't really care what his ratings are. This guy is an absolute playmaker. You can use him. I use him a lot when I play. Like I said, his zone coverage isn't as good as Kennard's. But this guy is just somebody that 6'5" with that speed, a decent hip power. Just a guy you want to use in the middle. And then we got another linebacker that's a really good zone coverage guy, Shaq Thompson. His stats, have 79 speeds, a little bit lower than I want, but he's still going to be faster than most tight ends that he's covering anyway. You can see the rest of his stats there, tackle, play rec, power, block shedding, all in the 80 range. But like I said, this guy right here has one thing that if you play a lot of zone is really going to be beneficial. He has one of the higher zone coverages at an 80, tapping out at an 80. I don't think there's a lot of other cards in the game that have that. Another guy in that vein is the team of the week, Hassan Reddick. This guy here is selling for about 13K. He's got just top-notch speed. 85 speed is what you need right there. Then his acceleration is pretty good too with an 86. I mean, this guy is just an athletic dream. Perfect for usering. Now, if you want to keep that speed and step it up in hip power a little bit, there's a good price guy out there by the name of Mark Barron. He's selling for about 23K, but at 6'2", he's got much better height than the last guy showed. You can see pretty much all of his stats are in the 80s, which is phenomenal, including an 85 hip power. That's really where you want to go right there. You want a guy that can run around and lay the wood. This is definitely going to be a good guy for that. So much improved in the height and much improved in the hip power. I'm trying to find his zone coverage real quick. Yeah, he's got an 80 zone, so once again, you can leave him to play alone, and he's going to do a good job. This guy's totally worth the money. Except we also got Stephen Gilmore. This is one of my all-time favorite cards. You can get a gauntlet version if you complete the gauntlet challenge. I don't think they're sellable, but you can get, I think it only takes 3 gauntlet, or maybe 2, to get an 85 overall. I think it's 2, actually, which is not too hard to get. So if you haven't done that, he's definitely a better version. But this is an A6 speed guy, A9 acceleration, great hands at a 79. He's got good height to it, 6'1". One of my favorite cards. Definitely a salary cap favorite for me. And here's a really underrated card. He's only selling for about 5. Marshawn Lattimore, team of the week, corner. This dude's got a 90 speed, so no matter what you play, I mean, I know his zone, his man isn't that great, but with that type of height and that type of makeup speed, I mean, this guy is perfect for cover 3, which is typically what I run. All of his other stats aren't that great, but that height and that speed is all you need, man, especially if you're playing against, you know, Randy Moss on the other side. You want somebody that can compete for balls, and this is the guy, dirt cheap. I don't know how he's only selling for 5. That's crazy. And then next up, we got another guy. This is another tournament favorite, Adrian Amos, 82 overall. He's 6 foot, but the key stat is his A7 speed, A6 acceleration. He's got pretty good zone coverage too, which is probably what he's going to be playing for the most part. But this guy is just a playmaker. You can get him for less than 18K. He's probably typically selling around 12 to 14K. I just popped this guy up. But, you know, an inexpensive, really good guy for your safety. And if you want to step it up and hit power a little bit, but you don't want to lose height and speed, Maurice Alexander, this guy's been in my budget beast since the beginning. His 85 hit power, though, is the big difference between him and some of the other guys I showed you. He's going to cost a little bit more, but not a lot more. And then another guy I got to throw in here, 83 overall, Keanu Neal. This was the guy I had for the longest time. He's selling for about 14K. Once again, hit power. This guy here is not as fast as some of the other guys. He's only an 81 speed, but I've played cover two with him, and he works out fine. He gets a lot of picks. This guy, I don't care what his stats say. He can play the deep half. Other than that, like I said, hit power is where it's at. I mean, I want guys that can force fumbles, and this is one of the better guys for that with an A7 hit power. So that's it. That's the list. If you guys have any players of your own, please share them with me and share them with the community in the comment section so we can know, you know, who's out there that we can get if we don't want to go out and spend a bunch of money to improve our team. And that's it. Other than that, thanks for watching, man. Money Shit out.